Much of the poverty that we see in urban areas today is of rural origin. It's rooted in the rural to urban migration that is taking place. And over the course of several discussions yesterday, it was clear that the only differentiating factor between rural and urban dwellers are actually the opportunities that are afforded to people in urban areas. To address these issues, the former president of India, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, highlighted a vision of transformation of rural India through launching a mega mission for provision of urban amenities in rural areas, also called Pura. Pura was envisaged as a self-sustainable and viable model of service delivery to be managed through an implementation framework involving local people, public authorities, and the private sector. I would now like to call upon Mr. Srijan Pal Singh, who brings the gospel of Pura straight from Dr. Abdul Kalam's place. Srijan has been officer on special duty to the former president, and in spite of having an MBA from the prestigious Indian Institute of Management, he has chosen to work in the public space. Srijan, I welcome you on stage, please.
Okay, good morning, everyone. Wonderful day. Gospels. I like the words which she uses. You know. Well, before I start, I have a message from Dr. Kalam for Sankalp about Pura, about how social enterprise can be a part of it. May I request the audio team to play that?
To address the participants of the Sankalp 2011 Social Enterprise Awards and Investment Forum, which is being organized in Mumbai this year. I'm happy to know that Sankalp is gathering which mentors and nurturers social enterprises focusing across high impact sectors like agriculture, rural business, education, clean energy, health, sanitation, technology for development and for water and water. With this network of number of investors and number of social enterprises, Sankalp can be an ideal ground for building the 21st century socio-economic development system. Today, I would like to discuss on implementation strategies for the creation of a unique sustainable development system for the nation and the world. The topic I have selected for today's discussion is Pura as a sustainable developed system. Pura means providing urban amenities in the rural areas. Now let us look at the components of a sustainable development. Dear friends, I would first like to discuss on what constitutes sustainable development. Sustainable development means integrated thoughts, action, which not only lead to financially robust system, but also keenly focus on societal development, environmental conservation, technological infusion, and the employment criteria. In the context of rural India, it would mean the evolution of socio-economic entities which transform the means of livelihood and quality of lifestyle for 750 million rural citizens with a customized and adaptable action plan which follows the route of citizen empowerment and capacity building. It could also require to build a society whose fabric is strongly bounded by a value system of harmony, respect for diversity, and care for the environment. Sustainable development would have to emerge as a system of a collective learning and continuous improvement to ensure that the products and services keep evolving to higher levels and progressively better income generation opportunities are locally available. Friends, when we discuss today about the opportunities and challenges of sustainable development system, we should keep all these aspects in mind. Now I'm going to talk to you economic development that is transforming India into a developed nation. There's a need to lift up the economic conditions and the lifestyle of over 300 million people out of 1 billion plus population. One of the reasons for this situation is that a large part of the growth comes from the manufacturing and services sector. The agriculture has been growing just about 3% over the past two decades, 3% of GDP past decade. If you have to uplift the 300 million people living below poverty line and provide improved quality of life, we have to ensure that the agriculture sector grows at least at 6% per annum. Now, friends, I am going to talk to you Pura as a sustainable development system, training period for the nation and its people. We stand 9 years away from the goal of achieving the vision for a developed India by 2020, and there has been a significant progress in all directions. Each step we take towards a developed nation also opens up a fresh challenge to overcome. The need of the hour is the evolution of the sustainable system, which acts as enablers and bring inclusive growth and integrated development to the nation. Friends, on 3rd of May, I was with 300 farmers from the Paliganj area in Bihar, where I interacted with them. I asked them about their issues and experiences. One farmer over there got up and said, "Dr. Kalam, we don't need any form of subsidy. For our development, we need electricity, water for irrigation, give us good seeds and good fertilizer, and give us the best of science. We can do it, and we'll be ready to pay." I am amazed by this spirit. Today, what is needed is not subsidies, but the empowerment model, and I am sure social enterprises are a great way to achieve this profile of sustainable development system. One such sustainable development system based on entrepreneurial thought and action is the mission of provision of urban amenities in the rural areas. It's called Pura. It involves four connectivities, namely physical, electronic, and knowledge, leading to economic connectivity. These have been done across a cluster of villages, about 20 to 50, depending on the population and density. Each Pura complex has to be based on the unique core competency of the villages within it. Hence, the entire country should have 7,000 Puras encompassing over 600,000 villages, covering 750 million people. The theme of Pura, apart from concentrating on reinforcing the agriculture, will emphasize an agro-processing, development of rural craftsmanship, dairy, fishing, silk production, and tourism, so that non-farm revenue for the rural sector is enhanced based on the core competence of the region. Also, the rural economy will be driven by the renewable energy such as solar, wind, biofuel, and conversion of municipal waste into power. In this approach, The aim is to make sustainable development using the core competence of the rural society. There are a number of operational puras across the nation, and government has also declared the mission for setting up puras in 9 states in the next 3 years. The need for an integrated platform for bringing all the puras ideas together and targeting the resources, minds, ideas and market linkages through an enterprise network is now being carried out under the provision of Pura Activated. In conclusion, these Pura complexes with their 4 connectivities would have transformed into a dynamic rural complexes with focus on employment potential for all the families of Pura cluster with all the connectivities. These Pura complexes will have its umbilical connectivity with the nearest university or a social organization. Let me present the visualization of Pura cluster based on the already operational Pura we have discussed. Provide dwelling units to all the village citizens with clean water supply and sanitation facilities. The village complex will have 100% literacy. Apart from upgrading the existing school, the complex will have a few colleges, world-class vocational training institution in construction, carpentry, welding, natural art, computer maintenance and services, IT-enabled services, PPO and a call center. People in the Pura complex will be able to get quality health care through telemedicine and also through mobile clinics via primary health center. They will be brought under corporate medical health care scheme. Each Pura village complex will be free from diseases like polio, TB, leprosy and malaria and other waterborne diseases. The infant mortality rate will be less than 10. The Pura complex will promote health care and floriculture products apart from agriculture in collaboration with the nearby agriculture universities and research institutions. There will be agro processing industries in each Pura. Creation of a dairy and fish farm in each Pura complex for providing additional non-farm revenue to farmers. Revival of all existing water bodies in the Pura cluster. Provision of employment to all employable people of the village through additional job in dairy, agro processing, construction, handicraft and tourism enterprises. Overall, per capita income of the Pura cluster should increase by 3 times and people living below the poverty line should come down to 0 in 6 years' time. I request to all the participants, social entrepreneurs, investors and other experts of Sankalp conference to consider what the nation needs, how it can be delivered in a sustainable manner. What is important to the 600,000 villages in the nation should be the consideration for Pura initiation, operation and Pura functioning. The collective energy of the sustainable enterprise needs to be channeled into productive development of 750 million rural citizens as a viable business proposition. My best wishes to all of you, success in all your missions. May God bless you.